Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Robert Hardhead, and I would like to welcome you to our story, a story for which today, the 19th of July, is a momentous one for all concerned with the Mary Rose.
Daybreak, the 19th of July, 1545. The Mary Rose lay at anchor in calm and tranquil seas. As morning turned to afternoon, the wind strengthened and the Mary Rose sailed to engage the French in battle.
The 19th of July, 471 years ago, to the day. The 19th of July, 1545, the day our story began, the day King Henry VIII watched in despair from Southsea Castle as the pride of his fleet sank beneath the waves. Author Christopher Sansom's own story, Heartstone, tells of that scene. Read for us by Damien Lewis.
Gone. I looked to where the Mary Rose had been. There was nothing to be seen now in the still bubbling sea, save the tips of the two masts a few feet above the water, some men still clinging to the fighting tops, and the floating sails.
Henry VIII's advisor, Lord Russell, wrote a few days later on the 23rd of July, 1545,
"I am very sorry of the unhappy and unfortunate chance of the Mary Rose, which should be cast away with all that were within her, which is a great loss of the men and the ship, notwithstanding that ye give me good hope that the ship shall be recovered, which I pray God may be so."
Perhaps Lord Russell's prayers were heard. Our story attracts today's historians as well. David Starkey.
The Mary Rose is a time capsule, the whole world of that day when she both sank, and thanks to an accident of preservation and a miracle of conservation, both died and lived for men. She's the English Herculaneum, Pompeii, and tomb of Tutankhamun, all rolled into one. And she's much more exciting than the lot of them.
And Dan Snow.
The loss of the Mary Rose and her crew also meant the loss of many thousands of objects. As a consequence, this museum houses the foremost collection of real Tudor artifacts anywhere in the world.
Here was a world of things that I could see and touch. A leather jerkin, half unbuttoned, a shoe worn down.
One of the last of those items to be raised from the seabed was the ship's bell. It was cast in a Flemish foundry, and the inscription translates to,
"I was made in the year 1510.
1510 was the year the Mary Rose was commissioned. That bell sounded the watches on board the Mary Rose.
And it sounds again for us now to signify the next chapter in the story of the Mary Rose. And so our story continues. This is the best view of the Mary Rose that there has been for 471 years. A clear line of sight of all deck lines. But let's turn the clock back once more, just briefly. This time a mere 50 years or so, to when Alexander McKee decided to search for